Right now, 7,700 homes are still without power and could be for several days. This morning, more than 30,000 people couldn't turn the lights on. The areas hit the hardest, the South Hill and Airway Heights. Avista says they have all hands on deck to get everyone's power up and running as soon as possible. 4 News Now reporter Katerina Christophis is working for you to find out when that will happen. Katerina.
Where in the overnight snow caused trees and branches to fall on Avista's power lines. We saw residents just a few minutes ago moving these branches out of the road so they're not in people's way. And while Avista is trying to get the power up and running, they say it could take a long time.
Never seen this happen. I've been here 25 years.
John Farini says it all started at 12:30 this morning.
So there was a really bright flash and a loud noise that woke me up and the power went out at the same time.
He thought the power would be restored by the time he woke up, but it turns out he, along with thousands of others, may be without power for several days.
I've never lost power at this house. This is the first time this house has not been without power.
We have currently on 50 crews. We have all of our available internal Avista resources as well as our contracted partners are helping us.
But even with all of that help, crews are still struggling.
Having the trees down actually slows down the restoration effort. We have to have vegetation management crews out ahead of our crews to remove the trees so that we can then go restore the lines.
Avista says it's focusing on restoring power to its critical care customers first. Then they focus on high volume areas. Lastly, they'll start fixing individual service lines, which could take a few days.
Avista is always prepared for storm and trouble response. We're prepared for large storms or whether it be individual outages.
Yet many people were still caught off guard by this one, including Farini. But he says he's ready for whatever the next few days will bring.
Now, Avista also wants you to treat all power lines as if they were energized. So if you see them, do not get near them. And if you see them in the middle of the road, don't drive over them. Instead, just take a different route. Aaron.